SOBs. We're out here. We're Crosswicks Creek Canoe Access. We're gonna wade. I brought my Corker boots. We're gonna wade down the stream. I brought pretty much essentially just my ultralight and some ultralight tackle. I brought some jig heads and some crawlers, some small crankbaits, inline spinners, little crappie magnet and trout magnet type stuff. A few things. I even have this little tiny hula popper that I'm gonna start with this morning. Sunrise was 10 minutes ago, and we just got here. We're gonna set everything up to get ready to go, get ready and get out there. So let's get to it. Spot. I'm gonna try this little popper. I got fluorocarbon on, which isn't necessarily the best for a popper. This fluorocarbon sinks, but it's just a very little popper, so. Oop, got hit. Wow, guys, look at this. Water must be real low. Every time I've ever been here, this is like a fishable little area in here. It's crazy. Whew, we're muddy. Whew, this water's chillier than I thought it would be. This water is way low, so we're gonna have to find some deep pools where the fish are hiding. Might be a little bit tricky here today. Got this cool little pool back off the main stretch here. I wonder what the chances of something being stuck in it are. Ow. Hoo-wee. Ow. Great, I left my pole over there. Oh boy. Hoo-wee. My ass is probably ridiculously muddy now. Keys are all muddy. Got mud everywhere. Holy crap. That was a hell of a slide, guys. Hell of a slide. Hoo-wee. All right, guys, let's give this little pool a try. This looks like a little hangout spot. We got a little, like, tributary running in. And we got some movement to my right. I'll show you guys in a minute. We got a little swing going on over there. Super humid today, guys. Super humid. Alright. There's a swing I was talking about, if you guys can see it. Whew. This gets a little bit deeper than I thought it was, but that's okay. Look at this tire that's in here, guys. Like, look how soft this thing is. It just, like, collapses on itself. I wonder how long a tire has to be sitting in the water to get that brittle. Comment down below what you think. All right, guys, so it seems like we might have a little bit of a, I'm not gonna call it a deeper pool, but I'm gonna say a little deeper. It's not deep. But, ooh, fish on, guys. There we go. Finally got one on the popper. Woo! Little largemouth. Now, I wasn't expecting to be catching anything big today. We're just fishing a little creek in the end of August. But there we go. Beautiful little creek largemouth. Fun to catch. There we go, fish on, guys. Ooh, this is a nicer bass. Or, ooh, fish off. That might have been a big pickerel. Damn. Look at that, guys. Scale on the hook. What the hell was that? I got a scale like that. Was that like a little carp that I sideswiped or something? I don't think so. It looked like a bass or a pickerel, but who knows? All right, SOBs, I just figured I'd hop on and talk to you about something real quick. Now, when you're out fishing, just, you know, giving you guys a little tip. Today I'm creek fishing, but it really doesn't matter what kind of fishing you're doing, specifically freshwater fishing. You want to find patterns, okay? So I've noticed at the beginning I got a little bite from what seemed like a bluegill. I caught this little largemouth over here, and I got another bite from something else that was a little larger, just lost it over here as well on the popper. Now, all these bites I've gotten, if you guys could see this, let's walk over here, have been right after a shallow area that's kind of ripply, okay? So that's causing turbulence in the water, causing aeration. So now that this water's a little more oxygenated. Now, right after those ripply areas, we have a turn here that gets slightly deeper and has a lot of laydowns and sticks and all sorts of hard structure on it. Now, every hit I've gotten today has been directly after a ripply area in a slightly deeper pool right next to hard structure. So, I'm not saying you shouldn't, you know, fish other types of areas on your way down. There might be fish that are in different patterns as well. But as I'm working my way down the creek, I'm gonna pay more attention and specifically work very well these little deeper areas directly after the ripply shallows. Just because that's where they seem to be hanging out today, specifically on the hard structure. So I've worked with the popper. I'm gonna tie on like an inline spinner and work through the same area, see if we can pull anything else out, and then keep moving down creek. Let's get to it. Not expecting anything in this little area, but I'm gonna give it a shot. Fish on? Oof, I got hit, guys. Got hit and pulled sideways real hard. So I don't know if these Panther Martin hooks are just garbage or what. I mean, it feels pretty pretty hard, or pretty sharp, reasonably sticky. Fish on. What do we got? Oh, it's a little bluegill. There we go, guys. Second species of the day from this little tiny pool. Check this guy out. He's got some beautiful little colors. See that? Awesome. All right. There was another hit. Wow. These bluegill are ferocious in here. They're just not getting the hook every time. There we go. Oh, missed them. Fish on, guys. Probably a whole pot of bluegills. This one's definitely a little bit bigger than the last one. Same kind. I think this is like a red-breast sunfish, maybe. I'm not that great at identifying the bluegill species, but this may be a red-breast sunfish. Comment down below. Let me know if I'm right. I'm sure some of you guys know sunfish a little better than I do. There he goes. All right, guys, I just watched some sort of fish at the top up here. Fish on. There we go. Another bluegill, a little bit bigger this time. This is Main Creek, though. Where we were fishing before was a little offshoot. There we go, guys. Another little bluegill. Gone. Something hit me. Right after I popped over that log. Right next to the hard structure, after some ripples, guys. Almost every time today. Boom, again, right next to the structure. Another bluegill, but all these fish seem to be staging up right in the same spot. Like I said to you guys before, it's patterns. We got a little bit of a shallow area, rippling, oxygenating the water, come down a little bit of deep area, some hard structure, and these guys are just loaded up in there. There we go. Wow, guys, I caught a little microfish. I didn't realize I had a fish on at first. Here we go, little largemouth. Smallest largemouth that we've caught today. And once again, guys, it's Ripley, and this is where two places converge. That's why I stopped here. It just looks super, super juicy. But there we go, another little fish. He barely even has any of his lateral lines or anything yet. There we go, another fish. Two casts in a row right in this little spot. Bluegill this time. And there we go, guys. Another pretty one. There we go, guys. Another one. Whoa! So, guys, this is a better largemouth, and there was another largemouth, just the same size or larger, following him around after this thing. There we go, guys. He's been eating up too. He's a fatty. I mean, he's tiny, but he's fat. Awesome. Fish on. Watched him come get it. Another largemouth. Oh, threw it right there. Damn. There we go, guys. Looks like a bluegill again. There we go. Oh, wow, that's funny. There's a fish, but there was a fish on it instantly there, even with the leap on it. Loaded with bluegills up in here. Fish on, there we go. It's gotta be a little largemouth, some fight to it. Yeah, a little largemouth. All right, here we go. Another little largemouth guy, perfect. These little creek largies are fun. All right, guys, I tied on a jig head crawler, just try to bounce it through here. Maybe we can catch something a little different, or just everything in the creek. Fish on. This one seems like a little bit better of a fish. Whoa, guys, cool. Another species. Check this guy out. I wasn't expecting this. This is super cool though. I think I may have caught this on the channel one other time. Check this guy out. It's a fall fish. Pretty positive that's what that is a fall fish. Awesome little fish. All right, let's get this fall fish back. There he goes. I knew he hit a little harder than the regular bluegill. That's awesome. All right, guys, it's the first fall fish I caught this year. Put a really small chunk of bluegill on, or nightcrawler on, so let's see. There we go, guys. Every cast with this thing. A little bit bigger of a bluegill. Come on, bud. There we go. Ooh. Well, he's back in the water. All right, guys, there's just tons of fish down here. I would really love to jig this thing around and catch a little carp or something. Literally every freaking cast. All right, there's another one, guys. There we go. Largemouth that time. Okay size one, actually. Come on, bud. Definitely biggest bass of the day. There we go. Now that's a nice creek bass right there. Now see this sucker? Set the pole down. Try to give him a quick rinse off. All right, will you look at this guy? Here we go. This right here, that's a nice creek largemouth right there. Little creek like this, boom, nice. All right, guys, here we go. There he goes, nice largemouth. All right, so it seems like we're picking through a whole bunch of fish that we missed out on with just the spinner. All right, guys, another little tip for you. If you guys are newer into fishing, don't know that much, don't catch that many fish, if you come to a little creek like this, get yourself a little moon eye jig head or just a small jig head. Get yourself a tub of night crawlers. Take your night crawler, just thread it right on the end of your jig head like this, almost like it was some sort of soft plastic, and start tossing in and jigging that sucker around. You are almost guaranteed to catch fish, especially in the warmer months of the year. There's another one, another largie. Whoo, almost fell down biting this thing. All right, another one of the nicer largies we've caught today. There we go, guys. It's another decent creek largemouth. Like I said, a jig head crawler, toss it in there, you're gonna catch fish. There we go, another fish. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I am really surprised how many largemouths we're nailing out with this jig head crawler. I was expecting more bluegill and things like that, but we've caught quite a few largemouth. Now that's another just small creek largemouth, but another fish. There we go. Little baby bluegill. There we go, fish on. There we go. Ooh, first pickerel of the day, another species, check that out. The tiny little guy barely even has chain yet. That's cool, but I think that's species largemouth two, species four, I think, for the day. Check that out, guys. There we go, little guy, little bluegill. Little bluegill. Here we go, guys. All right. Might have gotten too close to this little pool, but there was definitely some movement up in it. There we go. A little bluegill, but he smashed that thing. Well, redbreast, I think. He hit it hard, this guy. There we go. Fish on. What is that? Another pickerel? Another fall fish? Cool. Two of these things in a day, huh? Ooh, Come on, bud. I think he broke me. He did. He snapped my line. But hey, I got him, so I got my jig head. You hear that, guys? They make such weird noises. I'm gonna set my jig head down right there. I don't really have anything. Ooh, this guy's gotten hit before, if you guys saw. Oh, there he goes. Really cool looking fish, though. I don't know what you guys think about those little fall fish, but they're not fish that I catch often. Pretty sure that I've caught two today, and I've only caught three in my entire life. So there we go, another little guy. We have to cut out some of these little guys. We're catching so many little bluegill. There we go. Watch this guy take it, little largy. There he goes. There he goes. Quick release, guys. Quick release. There we go. He's fighting like a bluegill. Yep. Maybe. Looks like it. Yes, sir. There we go. Fish on him. Largy, maybe? Nope, another fall fish. Cool, man. I wonder if it's the same one. There we go. Another little red breast guy. When you guys are, you know, walking through the woods like this, inside of a creek, always keep a close eye out, because I don't know if you guys could tell, but we got this nice guy right here. There he goes. Boom. Coming right at me. He a big old snake. Well, he's not that big, but he's a northern water snake. Cool looking buddy. See if we can catch a little bluegill and throw it over to the snake. Ooh, it's not a bluegill. It's a bass, decent sized. Nope, don't. You're not getting under that tree, buddy. All right. And ended up getting a nice little largemouth. Was hoping for a little bluegill to try to feed that, but look at this guy. Nice little largemouth. Some of these creek largemouth are nice little guys, and they fight real nice in this current. And this isn't a huge largemouth by any means, maybe a pound or so, but when they live in this current, they fight just harder, man. It's great. There's another one. We'll get this guy back. And there he goes. Certainly can get mad at a decent-sized largemouth like that. That was instant. Bluegill this time. I don't think this bluegill is by any means small enough to try to feed that snake. So we're going to put a new nightcrawler on and get back to it. There we go. Looks like another little largy. Ooh, jumper. Cheeks bleeding a little bit, but there we go, another little largy. So much fun. There he goes. They love to go right up underneath that, right there. Got one. Another little largy, huh? There's tons of little largies right here. And there we go. Another nice creek largy. A hit when it hit the water. There we go. What do we got here? Little bluegills. What do we got? What do we got? Ooh, here's a first for today. Look at this, guys. We got a crappie. Almost keeper size crappie. Now, I'm not keeping fish today, but if I was, this would be just about keeper size. Check that out. I think that's species 5, 2 bluegill. Yeah, I think that's 5 species now, guys. Check that out. Just catching everything in this creek today. Tell you what, that's one really fun thing about fishing little creeks like this. This creek has so many different species in it. You never know what you're gonna catch into. Another night crawler on. See if we can get hooked on anything else. Other than snags. That one was a fish. Popped it off a snag, fish came out and grabbed it. And again, I think this is a regular sunfish, but I'm not sure. It's pretty yellow on the bottom. All right, guys, this is another little spot, not far from where I was just fishing, that just looks juicy. Got a lay down here. Looks like a little area with some depths to it. There we go, fish on. Another fall fish maybe? It's freaking out like it. Ooh, a kitty fish. Here is species number what? 6 for today? Got ourselves a nice little channel kitty. What the hell? There we go. There we go, guys. Another nice little species. Channel cat. Perfect. There we go. What do we got here? This is a mess, guys. I'll show you this fish in just a second. So, all right, let me try to get out of the water. Whew. All right, there we go. Another nice little channel kitty. Funny, guys, it seems like almost every little deep hole here is a little honey hole. Five or six species on the day. There we go. Wow, that guy jumped and I flung him towards us. Decent sized bluegill. There we go. Like I said, just a little honey hole, every little hole in here. There we go, fish on. Looks like a just a decent sized bluegill. By decent size, I mean a behemoth of a bluegill. Holy crap, guys. Look at this freaking bluegill. This might be the biggest bluegill I've ever caught in my life. Holy shit. Guys, this is definitely the biggest bluegill I've ever caught in my life. Look at this freaking thing. Holy crap. All right, I'm going to stop talking about this bluegill, and I'm going to let him go. Whew. Trying to let him go nicely, but he didn't want nothing to do with that. Wow, that was a huge bluegill. All right, guys, it looks like there's a little bit of depth right in between these two trees here, and I'm literally going to try to vertical jig it. There we go. Vertical jigging right here. Another little bluegill. Wow, guys, it's crazy. I was vertical jigging a little deep spot in between these two trees. Boom. We go, fish on. Little largy. All right, there we go. Another little creek largy. All right, SOBs. Unfortunately, I gotta cut my day a little short. I have some problems going on at home, so I'm gonna have to head out of here. But ooh, look at that fish jump right behind us. I don't know if you saw that, but we really had a great day. We caught multiple fish of multiple species. We caught channel cats, fall fish, bluegill, redbreast, largemouth, crappie. We caught so much stuff. It's really 5 or 6 species, something like that we caught. It's crazy. And I don't even know how many fish. It's dozens at this point. I'm sure I probably cut some of the smaller ones out at this point because there's a lot of fish I caught today. A lot. So, like I said earlier, if you guys are newer getting into fishing, don't fish that much, or just trying to figure it out, learn, get yourself onto a fish or two, find yourself a creek like this and find a little deep hole in it. And by deep hole, I mean relative to the creek. If the creek is 1 foot deep, find a spot that's 2 feet deep, you know? Find a spot that's 18 inches deep, just a little bit of a depth change. Throw a little jig head crawler in there and you're almost guaranteed to catch fish. I've caught fish constantly since I started using jig head crawler. Now, I caught some stuff on lures before that, working all these same areas, but the jig head crawler really pulled everything out of there. So, like I said, if you guys are new, give that a shot. Hope you guys liked this video. If you did, smash that like button. Drop a comment. Tell me if you like creek fishing, or if you want me to make more of these creek fishing videos. Subscribe, you get to see all my new stuff coming out. Till next time, guys. Peace.